Okay, boys and girls, girls and boys, welcome to your English classes. Today is a special day because it's your exam, okay? It's your monthly exam, your mensual exam. Today we have 2 hours. In the first hour, we are going to remember the vocabulary and the grammar. And we also have classes, okay? And this class is in your exam. And in the second hour is your exam, okay? So I repeat again. In the first hour, we have classes and a short review, a remember. And in the second hour, you have your exam, okay? So let's start with the class. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, boys and girls, look. The last class we learned the possessive. Remember? I have got, you have, I have got, she has got, haven't got, okay? But today, we are going to learn possessive, okay? Possessive, but possessive too. Okay, there are many ways in which we can talk about possessive. Hay varias formas in which, en las cuales, we can talk about possessions, okay? And these possessive are very, very, very extremely easy, okay? And the possessive are these. Apóstrofe es or apóstrofe, okay? We have two possessive here. Apóstrofe es or apóstrofe, okay? So, let's see how we use this possessive. ¿Cómo we use this possessive, okay? Let's see. Okay, possessive, next. Okay, listen, look. We use the possessive case, we use the apostrophe and s or apostrophe to talk about possessions, okay? To talk about possessions. To show that something or an object, okay? An object belongs, is the possession of somebody, is the possession of a person, okay? So, that's the first use, the primer el uso. Look, to show that something belongs to somebody. In other words, en otras palabras, to show that an object, okay, an object is the possession of a person. An object is the possession of a person, okay? For example, Mary's bag. The bag, okay? The bag belongs, is the possession of Mary, okay? John's ball. Ah, the ball is the possession, belongs to John, okay? An object is the possession of a person, okay? That's the first use of the possessive case. Teacher, what is the possessive case? ¿Qué es el possessive case? Apóstrofe es or apóstrofe o apóstrofe sola. Look, here we have apóstrofe es, apóstrofe es, okay? Now, we also use use number two, listen, use number two, to explain the relationship between two or more people. Teacher Angelo, what is the relationship? ¿Qué es relationship in Spanish? Relación, okay? Family members or boyfriend and girlfriend, wife and husband. Relationships, okay? For example, Tom's uncle, family member. So, this uncle belongs, has a relation with Tom, tiene una relación with Tom, because he's the uncle, is the family member, okay? Another example is this, Peter's friend, okay? This friend has a relation with Peter. Why? Because that friend, that is the friend of Peter, have a relationship, okay? So, number one, we use to talk about the possession of an object, okay? And number two, to talk about relationships, relaciones. Understood this part? Yes or so-so? Who can tell me? Yes or so-so? Come on, so-so. Okay. Okay, but I need to hear you. Yes or so-so? Okay, Jared, John, Allison, David, Matias, Mia, Sophie, Giselle, Paulo, Jimmy. Understood yes or so-so? Come on, I need your participation, boys, girls.
So-so.
So-so. Okay. Let's practice, okay? Let's practice. Look, here I have Pepito, okay? The name of this boy is Pepito. Pepito, okay. He's my friend Pepito. Okay? And here, what is the name of this object in English? What is the name? You know, it's your vocabulary. What is the name of this object? Glasses, perfect. So here I have glasses, and here I have sis. Come on, a family member, sister.
Sister.
Okay. Very good. Here I have her sister. Okay, here I have his sister. Okay, so here I have an object, okay, an object, and here I have a person, okay, a person. And let's create some sentences. Let's create some sentences, okay? And let's follow the model here. Sigamos el modelo. For example, here we have Mary's bag. Mary's bag, okay? The bag, the school bag, okay, the school bag belongs, is the possession of Mary. Now, como I say that the glasses is the possession of Pepito? How I say that sentence? ¿Cómo diría? The glasses is the possession of Pepito. Look at the example. Look at the example here. Miren el example. Mary's bag. John's ball. Now, an example with glasses and Pepito. Volunteer. Nobody really. Come on, boys. It's easy. Think about it. Okay, Mia Montoya, please. Activate your microphone, Mia. Okay, very good, Aixa, that's perfect. Okay, Mia is there. Mia, are you there? ¿Estás allí, Mia?
Sí, teacher.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Mia. Mia, please, try to tell me an example. Trata de decirme un example. With glasses and Pepito. Very good, Jarlet. And Aixa is perfect. Okay, tell me, please, Mia.
Pepito's glasses.
Very good. Pepito's glasses. Very good, Mia. Excellent. To write a possession, you only need to write the name of the person, apostrophe S, and the object. Very easy. The name of the person, apostrophe S, and the name of the object or the relation. For example, look. Look, here I have a notebook, okay? Here I have a notebook, so I say Angelo's notebook. Very easy. Here, thank you, Emily. Here, for example, I have a book. Look, here I have a book. So I say Angelo's book. Here I have a glasses, right? So I say, my name is Angelo, but possession, you say Angelo's glasses. Okay, it's very, very easy. So let's see. Aixa, please help me in number two. Please help me in number two. Here we have the sister. Tell me a sentence, please, sister and Pepito. Aixa Ramirez, tell me a sentence, please. Aixa, are you there? Okay, very good, Aixa, perfect, but activate your microphone, please.
Pepito's sister.
Very good, Pepito's sister, very good, excellent. Number one, the name. Number two, apostrophe and S. And number three, the possession, the object or the person. Okay, now, easy or difficult? Jared, tell me, easy or difficult?
Easy.
Easy, right? Come on, it's easy. Very good, perfect. Let me see that chat. No, John Angel, don't copy. It's record. It's in your platform. Está la plataforma, don't worry. Very good. It's very, very easy. So let's go to the next PPT, to the next PowerPoint. Listen, here we are. Okay, boys and girls, girls and boys, listen, there are some rules, okay? And these rules are very easy, but please listen to me, okay? Rule number one. Rule number one. Okay? If the noun is singular noun, listen, singular noun, we use apostrophe en S. Okay? Thank you, Mia. Now, listen. If the noun is singular, we use apostrophe en S, okay? Singular noun, apostrophe en S. For example, the boy, boy, singular or plural, boy, singular or plural? Everybody, tell me, boy, singular or plural?
Jared, singular.
Very good, singular, so I use apostrophe en S, okay? The boys, ball, very good. Now look, Emily, singular or plural, Emily? Okay, tell me, singular or plural? I want to hear you. Very good. Thank you, Emmanuel. Singular, very good. So I use apostrophe en S. Yes, John Angel, thank you. Apostrophe en S, okay? Very, very easy. If the noun, okay, the noun, el sujeto is singular, we use apostrophe en S, okay? Rule number one. Rule number two. Look at here. Look, rule number two. Plural noun. If the noun is plural, and ends in the letter S, okay, ends in the letter S, finish in the letter S, we use apostrophe, okay? We only use apostrophe. So listen again, listen. Rule number two. If you have a plural noun, you have a plural noun. And the plural finish, okay, ends in the letter S, ends, finish in the letter S, okay, in the letter S, we use apostrophe, only apostrophe, okay? For example, the girls, singular or plural, girls.
Plural.
Plural, very good. And in what letter finish, girls? In what letter finish? ¿En qué letter finish?
S.
Very good. So, we use only the apostrophe. We only use the apostrophe. Okay, so, go back. Rule number one. If the noun is singular, apostrophe and S. Rule number two. If the noun is plural, okay, plural, ends in the letter S, finish in the letter S, we use apostrophe, okay? Understood this? Yes or so-so? I want to hear you. Yes or so-so? Come on, I want to hear you. Understood? Yes or so-so?
La plural no entendí muy bien.
Thank you, Aixa. Thank you so much. Okay, the plural no. Okay, let me see. For example, listen. Chairs. Singular or plural? Chairs.
Plural.
Plural. Very good. In plural, you use apostrophe S or apostrophe?
Apostrophe.
Very good. Apostrophe. Very good. Okay. For example, let me see. Students. Singular or plural?
Plural.
Very good. Apostrophe yes or only apostrophe?
Only apostrophe.
Only apostrophe. Very good. Because chairs, tables, students, computers, windows, doors, books, notebooks, cell phone, blah, blah, blah. Ends, finish in the letter S. And you use apostrophe, only apostrophe, okay? Now, boys and girls and boys, listen to me, okay? Listen to me, Here, we have a comodín, okay? Here, rule number three, you have a comodín. Tenemos un comodín, look. In the name of people, okay? If the name of people, listen to me. Rule number three. If the name of a person, ends in the letter S, ends, finish in the letter S, you can use apostrophe or you can use apostrophe and S, okay? You have two options. Both options, option number one and option number two is okay. It's okay. Both are correct. Ambos son correct, okay? Listen, if the name of a person, ends, finish in the letter S, pueden agregar apostrophe S or only apostrophe, okay? It's a comodín. Both options are okay. For example, Doris hat. You can use apostrophe S or Doris hat, only apostrophe. Both options are okay. Okay? Understood this, yes or no? Tell me, yes.
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, I'm going to read that. Okay, Emmanuel, thank you. Oh, thank you, Yarle, thank you. Okay, that's perfect. Okay, so here we have number one, number two, and number three. Now, listen up. We have, number one, number two, and number three. Only two rules, okay? Three rules, sorry. Number one, number two, and number three. Number four is not necessary, okay? Number four is not necessary. Look, here we have girls, okay? Here we have girls, friend, okay? Girls, friend. You need to tell me what option is correct, okay? Look at the sentence. Look at the sentence. Okay, here I have a two sentences. Girl's friend, girl's friend. What option is correct? Number one or number two? What option is correct here? Girl's friend, number one or number two? Okay, Giselle say number one. Ariel say number two. Matias say number two. Mia say number one. Emily say number one. Oh, come on, we have, they are equals, huh? There are three numbers, two.
Teacher, the two answer is correct.
Number two. Okay. Aixa, for you, number one or number two? Which one is correct?
One.
Thank you. Number one is the correct answer. Number one is the correct answer. Number one, because girls, is singular or plural, girls?
Plural.
Plural, very good. And for plural is apostrophe S or apostrophe?
Only apostrophe.
Only apostrophe, very good. And look, here is the same example, look. It's here, look. The girl house, the girlfriend is the same, okay? Remember, please, singular, apostrophe S. Plural, only apostrophe, okay? Only apostrophe. In names, the name of people, you have both options. Both options are correct. Listen, don't worry. In the name of a person. No se preocupen en el nombre de un person that finish in the letter S, que termine en la letra S. Because if you use apóstrofe en S, it's okay. If you use apóstrofe, it's okay. Cualquiera de los dos que utilicen en una persona que acabe en S, is okay. Okay? So, let's do some exercises. Let's do some exercises. And then we go to your book, okay? And then we go to your books. Let's see. Here, I have the family tree of the Simpsons. The Simpsons, thank you, Emmanuel. The Simpsons family tree, okay? And we are going to create sentences about this family tree using apostrophe en S or a apostrophe, okay? For example, I choose bar, okay? I choose bar, look. I choose bar. Let's write the relationship of these people with bar. Hay que escribir la relación of these people with bar, okay? For example, look, here I have a sentence. Look at the example, please. I have Homer is Bart's father. Bart's father. Okay? Bart's father. Homer is Bart's father. Okay? So, let's write a sentence about March. Who wants to help me? ¿Quién me ayuda? About March. Look, there you have an example, Homer is Bart's father. About March, who can help me? Volunteer to help me? activate your microphone, volunteer to help me. Come on, you can do it, boys, girls. Volunteer, volunteer.
Marge is Lisa's mother.
Okay, but Lisa or Bar?
Lisa, Lisa.
Ah, okay, but we are writing about Bar. Estamos escribiendo sobre Bar. It's perfect.
Marge is Bar's mother.
Bar or Bar's?
Marge is Bar's mother.
Mother, very good. Marge is Bar's mother, very good. Let's write about now Abraham, okay? Abraham, look. Abraham.
I escuché de Lisa.
Okay, no, it's Bar, but very good, perfect. Now, volunteer to help me about Abraham. Abraham, volunteer.
Abraham is Bar.
Abraham, look.
Grandfather.
Okay, Abraham. Abraham is. Bar's
grandfather.
Grandfather. Very good. Perfect. Now, let's write about Selma. Selma, let's see. Ah, let's remember the vocabulary about family members. Let's see. Volunteer. Now, Herbert. Volunteer to help me about Herbert.
Herbert is Bart's uncle.
Very good. Perfect. Let's see. More example. Let's see if you remember. Link. Link.
Link is Bart's cousin.
Very good. Link is Bar's cousin. Very good. Excellent, Aixa. Link is Bar's cousin. Very, very good. So, boys and girls, girls and boys, do you have questions about apostrophe en S or apostrophe? Questions? Yes or no? No? I want to hear you. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, tell me your question, please. Dime tu pregunta.
Eso es lo mismo para objetos.
It could be, but remember, an object can have a possession. Un objeto no puede tener una posesión. For example, I can say cell phones, glasses. Los lentes del cell phone. No, right? Or I can say computers, book. It's weird. It sounds a little weird, but you can use. Okay? So, boys and girls and boys, very, very quickly, let's go to your books. Okay? Let's go to your books, please. Yes, Mia, it's in your exam. Let's go to your books, please, boys and girls and boys. Very, very quickly, please. We are on page 27, okay? We are on page 27, okay? We are on page 27, please. Let's go to page 27, okay? 10 seconds, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Okay? You have already this page because the last class we complete these exercises here. We complete the last class. So you have this page. Ustedes tienen esta hoja. Let's go to activity number 6. Okay? Let's go to activity number 6, which is the easiest. Is the easiest. Okay? Oh, sorry. We have complete activity number 6. Yes or no? No, right? Or yes? Okay. No, okay, okay. Sorry, sorry. Let's complete activity number 6. Okay? Here we have a family tree. Okay? Here we have a family tree. Now, on the top, we have Jean and Margaret. Jean is the sister, the cousin, the brother, the grandfather. What is Jean? Orally, help me, please. Orally. Who is Jean? Father, cousin, grandfather, uncle, brother. Who is Jean? Volunteer to help me, orally. Come on, orally on the chat, no, please. Excellent, Alonso. Alonso say, Jean is the grandfather. Very good. Jean is the grandfather. Now, Jean is the grandfather. And Margaret. Come on, I need, very good, Mia, but please, orally, Mia, orally. On the chat, no, please. Very good, Emily Aixa, but orally, please.
Grandmother.
Grandmother, very good. Very, very good. Let's see. Behind, we have Lisa is the mother. Lisa is the mother. And Colin. Brother, cousin, or father?
Father.
Very good. Father, very good. Very, very good. Okay, here we have mother, Lisa, Colin, father, and Richard. Richard is the sister, aunt, or uncle?
Uncle.
Uncle, very good. Richard is the uncle. And Luis, Richard is the uncle. And Luis?
Aunt.
Aunt, very good. Perfect. So, Sophie is me, es ella. And who is Rachel for Sophie? They have the same mother and the same father. Tienen el mismo mother and father. Who is Rachel for Sophie?
Sister.
Very good. Sister. And Rachel is the sister. And Josh?
Brother.
Brother. Very good. And Gemma, Joe, and Mark are the cousins. Cousins. Very good. They are the cousins. Let's check your answers, and your answers are perfect. Okay, your answers are totally perfect. Okay, we have finished the family tree. Okay, grandfather, grandmother, mother, father, uncle, aunt, brother, sister, cousins, and of course, me. Okay, that's perfect. Very, very good. We have finished activity number 6. And now, very, very quickly, let's complete activity number 5. Okay? Activity number 5. In activity number 5, we need to complete with apostrophe S. Okay? We need to complete with apostrophe S or apostrophe. Okay? Adriana Lopez, please, very quickly read sentence number 2, please. Read sentence number 2. Can you read, please, Susie?
Susie is Maria's sister.
Thank you. Susie is Maria's sister. Very good. Maria's apostrophe S or only apostrophe? Maria. Apostrophe S, very good. I put it here. Apostrophe Es very good. Emmanuel, please, read sentence number 3, Emmanuel.
Work in a mother shop.
Very good, mother shop. Apóstrofe S o only apóstrofe?
Apóstrofe S.
Very apóstrofe good. S. Perfect, apóstrofe S. Very good. Mia Montoya, please, read number 5, Mia Montoya.
Yeah. They're the boys trainers.
Very good. Boys trainers. ¿Apóstrofe o apóstrofe en S?
Only apóstrofe.
Apóstrofe. Apóstrofe.
Very good. Only apóstrofe. Very good. Giseli, please, very, very quickly, Giseli, number 5.
Janet is Luke's wife.
Very good. Luke, wife. Luke, apóstrofe en S o only apóstrofe?
Only apóstrofe.
Only apóstrofe. Ah, but Luke is singular or plural?
Apóstrofe S.
Apóstrofe en S because it's singular. Apóstrofe en S. Okay? Number 6. Sofía, please, very quickly, Sofía, read number 6, please.
The twins' PlayStation is new.
Very good. Twins, Sophie, twins. Apóstrofe en S o only apóstrofe?
Only apóstrofe.
Very good, Sophie, very good, Sofía. Only apóstrofe because twins is plural, plural, apóstrofe, singular, apóstrofe en S. Ok, apóstrofe en S. Very, very good. We have finished activity number 5, activity number 6. Ok, so boys and girls, girls and boys, you enter in 10 minutes. Ok,